Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
So students, in the last lecture we have estimated that how to calculate the rate law of a reaction and how to calculate the rate constant of a reaction when various kind of concentration of A and B was given. But now there are some essential numericals which we have to solve, and on that basis we could calculate that what is the rate law of a particular reaction. So let us see this kind of critical questions. So as mentioned on your screen, there is a question which says that the reaction C plus D will give you product. In this case, the rate of the reaction is increased by a factor of 4 when the concentration of C is doubled. When the concentration of C is double, the rate constant are also been increased by a factor of 4. And the next case is, the rate of the reaction is tripled when the concentration of D is tripled. So what is the order of reaction? And we have to write the rate law. So by this question, we have got a small idea that in this case, we have to calculate the value of X and the value of Y. Then only we could calculate, or we could say what will be the order of reaction, and then only we could say that what will be the rate law of this particular reaction. So let us see how can we calculate this kind of question, how can we do this kind of numerical. So let us go. So the reaction that is being provided to us is C plus D, that will give us a product. So based on this equation, I could write the rate law. The rate law can be written as rate is equals to K of concentration of C raised to X and D raised to Y. In this case, we don't know the value of X and we don't know the value of Y. But in the second criteria, they have given us a few conditions. So we will apply those few conditions and let us see how can we calculate or how can we get the value of X. So before that, what I have to do is I have to mark this equation as equation number 1. In the given data, they have said that the rate of the reaction by a factor of 4 will be increased when the concentration of C is double. So let us see what will happen or what will be the rate law when the concentration of C is being doubled. When concentration of C is being doubled, then the rate law will be rate is equals to K when the concentration of C is being doubled, which means 2C raised to X into D raised to Y. This is the equation that we'll get. And what we can do, the next thing, we could solve this equation and we'll get rate is equals to K 2 raised to X C raised to X and D raised to Y. So this is the equation that we have got by following the condition that they have provided us. So what I will do is I will mark this equation as equation number 2 so that it could be very useful in the future. इसी को कंटिन्यू करना था इसको मार्क भी कर रहा था रेट वन रेट टू करके, अभी इसको थोड़ा कंटिन्यू करा देता हूँ, अभी बोल देता हूँ ये रेट।
हाँ
हाँ करेक्शन अभी 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 कर सकता हूँ अभी। ओके कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ
चलेगा
ऐसा बोलने के। ओके बट सिंस दिस कंडीशन इज डिफरेंट, द इक्वेशन वन कंडीशन इज डिफरेंट एंड दिस इक्वेशन वन कंडीशन इज डिफरेंट, व्हाट आई विल डू इज आई मार्क द रेट ऑफ द फर्स्ट इक्वेशन एज R1 and the rate of the second condition equation as R2. Okay. Now, for the further thing, what we are going to do is, again, the value of K will be, since it is a rate constant, it would be the same. The demand of the question, or the question says that the factor, the rate of the reaction will increase by a factor of 4. In this case, what does it mean? It means that the rate of the second reaction is increased by 4 times that of the rate of first reaction. So I could write it as the rate 2 is equals to 4 times that of rate 1. So therefore, rate 2 divided by rate 1 is ultimately 4. This is the equation that we have got. I'll mark this equation as equation A. So what I'll do with the previous two equations, what I'll do is I will divide those equation, I'll divide equation 2 with equation 1 to get a particular value of x. So how can we do? Let us see. So dividing equation 2 by equation 1, we'll get the equation 2 was rate 2 is equals to k of 2 raised to x into c raised to x into d raised to y, while that of equation 1 was rate 1 k c raised to x and d raised to y. So let us see what are those values that could cancel out with each other. The first one is, since the rate constant will be the same for both of the reaction, it will cancel out. And the value of concentration will also cancel out with each other. So the thing that is left with us is rate 2 divided by rate 1. But according to equation A, we have got the value of rate 2 divided by rate 1, which is nothing but 4. So therefore, 4 is equals to 2 raised to x. Now, the value to find, that is x, is now very much easy. We can write this equation as 2 raised to 2 into 2 raised to is equals to 2 raised to x. Therefore, the value of x is nothing but 2. This is what we have got. Now, the value of x has been found. But the second criteria or the second condition of the question is also remaining. That is, the rate of the reaction is tripled when the concentration of D is been tripled. So what will be the order of reaction? They have been asked. So as we know, the first reaction we have mentioned, a general reaction, that is rate is equals to K C raised to X and multiply by d raised to y. But for the second condition, what they have provided us is the rate increases 3 times when the concentration of d is increased 3 times. So let us see what happens, or what will be the rate law when the concentration of d is been multiplied by 3 or it's been increased 3 times. when concentration of D has been tripled, then the rate law will be. So when the concentration D is been tripled three times, then what would be the rate law? We'll see. The rate would be, rate is equals to, but in this case we are talking about the third rate, that is I will mark it as rate 3, is equals to K C raised to X, and when the D is multiplied by 3 or is been increased 3 times, then 3 into D raised to Y. So this will give us a value, or this will give us an equation, K C raised to X, that is 3 raised to Y, and again D raised to Y. So this is the equation, and I will mark this equation as equation number 3. The next thing that they have provided us is the rate increases 3 times. So what they have provided us is rate 3 will be 3 times that of rate 1. Therefore, rate 3 divided by rate 1 will be 3. So I'll mark this equation as equation B. So this equation gives a value where the rate 3 is divided by rate 1. So I'll do the same. I'll equate equation 1 and equation 3, and I will divide the equation 3 with equation 1. So let us see what the value that we could get. So the rate 3 says, what I'll do is I'll divide equation 3 by equation 1. So the equation 3 was rate 3 is equals to K 3 raised to Y C raised to X and D raised to Y divided by rate 1, which was K C raised to X and D raised to Y. So let us see what are the values that would get cancelled out with each other. They are C raised to X and again C raised to X, D raised to Y and again D raised to Y. Since the rate constant are the same in both the cases, so this will cancel out with each other. And ultimately, we know the value of rate 3 divided by rate 1, which is nothing but 3. So I could say, or I could substitute the value of rate 3 divided by rate 1 as 3 is equals to, this is nothing but 3 raised to Y. So I could estimate the value of Y as 3 raised to 1 can be written as 3 raised to Y in this case. So therefore, Y will be nothing but 1. So ultimately, we have got the value of X as 2, and now we have got the value of Y as 1. Therefore, the order of reaction, which has a formula of X plus Y, will give us a value of 2 plus 1, which is nothing but 3. So the order of reaction is 3. But the final requirement is we have to write the rate law. So how could we write the rate law? Since we know the reaction is given as C plus D will give you product, so therefore the rate law can be written as rate of the reaction is equals to K C raised to X and D raised to Y. But the value of X has been calculated. We have recently calculated the value of X, which is nothing but 2. So C raised to 2, and for the value of Y we have calculated as it is 1. So therefore the rate of the reaction, which gives a rate law of rate is equals to K C raised to 2 and D raised to 1. So this is how we have calculated this kind of numerical. So I hope you have got an idea how to calculate these things. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you would like this video and you would share with your friends too. And please don't forget to subscribe eKida channel. Thank you so much.